Okay, today we are going to start our lecture number 6 on single phase induction motor. In our last class, we have discussed about that split phase induction motor structure, different structure, capacitor, split phase, resistance split phase, and all the different categories. And now we are going to discuss in our this class shaded pole motors and repulsion start motor. So these are the two other different starting methods based on which the motor has been called as shaded pole structure motor and repulsion start motor. Okay, so first we are going to discuss shaded poles motors. So if we see the structure, so this is my shaded pole structure. So if we can see here the pole are basically salient pole type, and it is divided into two different sections. Okay, so this is my shaded pole structure. So if we draw it, so let me draw it. So this is my salient pole structure, salient projecting type, rather we can say protruding type structure. This is my salient pole structure. So what I had did in case of this shaded pole induction motor, I have sectionalized this into two part. So one part is this and another part is this. So what we have done, so this is my unshaded portion and this is my shaded portion. Okay, this is only the 1/3 portion of the pole face and this is this 2/3 remaining portion, unshaded portion, 2/3 remaining unshaded portion. So what we basically do here, we have use a low resistance copper band. Here we use a low resistance copper band. This is also known as shaded coils. Shading coils or shaded coil. And in this fashion, we have constructed the shaded pole. And as we know, so the winding are around this shaded structure also and this unshaded structure also. And from here, one part, and again, this is go, and it will again wind the lower part of the poles. Okay. And then it will come in. And here in this two point, we have given the single phase supply. Single phase supply is given. So one of the feature of this shaded pole structure is here the starting torque is very low because the shaded pole motor has very low rating, as fractional horsepower, less than 50 watt. Generally, it is in the range of less than 50 watt. Now, what we have did? So here we have given the single phase alternating supply. Single phase AC supply. If I given, so now due to the transformer action, due to the transformer action, EMF ESC will produce, because due to this alternating AC supply, a alternating flux phi m will produce, which will link both this shaded and unshaded part. And we know from transformer action, if we draw the phasor diagram, so if this is my phi m, this will be my ESC, it will lag 90 degrees. So this is my phi m, it will lag 90 degrees. Okay, we have seen this in transformer working principle, we have seen this. Now what will happen? Now I am given supply to this poles, so a current will start flowing through this shaded poles. A current will start flowing through this shaded poles. Okay, and one more thing we should remember, that this angle between this phi m and EDC, it is not exactly 90 degrees. Its value of phase difference, the value of phase difference depends on this resistance and reactance value, resistance and reactance value of this copper shedding pole, resistance and reactance value of this copper shedding pole. This value depends the angle between these two, phi m and EDC. Okay. And this ISC lags EDC, ISC by certain angle. Okay. Suppose the angle is phi. So this is my phasor diagram of shaded pole. So let me quick recapitulate. So we know from transformer action, because alternating current is given to this pole, so a flux phi m will link up, and due to transformer action, EDC voltage will produce. So what is, if phi is also alternating in nature, so basically phi equals to phi m sine omega t or cos omega t. Okay. And we have seen in case of transformer that E equals to E max sin omega t minus of pi by 2. So these are the two equations of transformer. So it is lagging by 90 degrees because of this presence of phase difference. And the current which is producing in this shaded pole, that is ISC, which is lagging this EDC by certain angle, and that value depends on this resistance and reactance value of this copper ring. And due to this ISC current which is flowing through this shaded pole, it will link up with this shaded coil, which will produce this NI ampere turns. And if we divide it with the reluctance of the shaded pole, a flux is also produced due to this current ISC, which is in phase with this current, which is my phi SC. Now see that there is a production of two flux, one is phi M and one is phi SC, and between these two there is a time phase difference exists. There is a time phase difference exists, 90 degree plus phi. And one more thing, this is the axis of the phi M and this is the axis of the phi SC along the current of the shaded pole, so the axes are also not same, so a space angle is also exist. So what we have concluded here, so there exists a space angle, as well as there exists a space difference as well as time difference. So these are exist between phi m and phi sc. And these two are the condition of the production of rotating magnetic field. We have seen when we have studied the production of rotating, principle of production of rotating magnetic field. So, as because these two conditions satisfying, so in case of shaded pole also there is a production of very poor rotating magnetic field, and which will produce a very less amount of starting torque, very less amount of starting torque. Okay. So, very less amount of starting torque will produce, because the RMF which is producing in the air gap very weak in nature. Now, if we do the waveform, so what? So, this is my phi m and this is my phi sc. So, this is my phi m and this is my phi sc. And we have seen in case of phasor diagram just few minutes back that phi m is always leading phi sc. We have seen this just few minutes back. So, here we have represented. So, what will happen? The resultant flux also reach the shaded portion first, and then it will reach the peak of unshaded portion, and so on. Resultant flux which we will get, but by adding this ordinates of these two flux phi m and phi sc, we will get the resultant flux phi resultant. Okay, and it will reach the peak in unshaded portion first, and then it will reach the shaded portion. Similarly, the motor also rotate from unshaded portion towards the shaded portion. So, the rotation is also from unshaded portion to shaded portion. So, rotation is also from unshaded pole to the shaded pole. Okay, shaded. Now, if I want to reverse the rotation, so what I will do? So, if I want to reverse the rotation, what I will do? Again, I will cut that shaded part into further two sectionalized part. So, the structure will be this is my shaded part. This is my two portions of shaded part. This is my two portion of shaded part. And in this way, I will structure this arrangement I have to made. Okay, so this is copper band shaded part, here also the shaded portion, so there these two are shaded part and this is my unshaded main poles, and among these two part, one part I will make shorted and another part I will kept open, and this open part will decide the rotation of the shaded pole structure. Now, if we do a comparison study between in case of a split phase induction motor and shaded pole structure, the only difference between these two, here the shaded pole is acts as a starting winding or auxiliary winding. But the difference is that in case of shaded pole structure, the current ISC which is producing inside the auxiliary winding or shaded pole is due to this EDSC, due to the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. So, induction is come into the picture. Whereas, we have seen in case of split phase starting, the current, exciting current produced due to conduction. So, this is the difference. Now, what is the application of this motor? Where very less amount of starting torque is required, like tape recorder, movie projector, record player. So these are the few applications: tape recorder, movie projector, certain domestic fan. This is because if we draw the speed versus torque characteristics of this motor, it is very less. It is very less amount. Pre-starting is very less. So this is all about my shaded pole motor. Okay. So I have discussed all these things, and okay, this phasor diagram we have also discussed, and this is my torque speed characteristics. So see here, the starting torque is very less, and it is very less costly motor because it is used in tape recorder, movie projector, certain domestic fans, etc. The few applications. So now I will start. Repulse and start motor. So if we see the structure of, so this is my repulse and start motor. Here also we have given single phase supply in a single stator winding. The only difference we have made here we have used a distributed DC armature type rotor. Distributed DC armature type of winding we have used in rotor during starting, and here there is a commutator and brush arrangement also used, similar to the DC motors. Okay. Now the function of this commutator and brush arrangement is to divide the rotor circuit, into two parallel circuits, very similar to DC armature. And look, these brushes are shorted among themselves, and not connected to any external electrical circuit. So this is are shorted and no connection with external electrical circuit. So here we have given supply, which is single phase AC supply. We provide single phase AC supply, which is time varying in nature. So what will happen if we give AC supply? Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction come into picture, and IMF will produce is proportional to d phi by dt. So IMF will produce. And as because this rotor circuit is shorted with brass, a current will start flowing through the rotor, which will generate a flux phi r, which is along the brass axis. And there is an angle between this rotor flux axis, rather brass axis, or this stator magnetic field axis, or rather stator winding axis. Okay. Now I will consider different position of this alpha. Now suppose alpha equals to 90 degree. Now suppose alpha equals to 90 degree, what will happen? So now alpha equals to 90 degree. Okay. So if alpha equals to 90 degrees, so this is my stator winding axis, so this is my rotor flux axis, and this angle is 90 degrees. This is my phi r, and this is my stator winding axis. So in this position, when these two axes are in space quadrature, so there is no mutual induction between these two axes. So there is no production of EMF according to Faraday's laws of induction, and the rotor wheel fails to start. Okay, now this is for alpha equals to 90 degree position. Now suppose alpha equals to 0 degree, means these two axes coincide with each other. So these two axes coincide with each other. These two axes suppose coincide with each other. Here is my the rotor conductors are there. So this is my rotor, and outside that there is my stator is also there. So these are coincide with each other. Now in this position the maximum flux cutting will occur, so the induced EMF will be maximum, so the current will produce will also maximum in nature. But since these two are coincide with each other, so the torque angle between them are 0 degree, or rather we can say that the two Lorentz force will which will produce inside this repulsion start motor will cancel each other. So in this alpha equals to 0 degree position also it will fails to start. Now what next position? I will keep this alpha anywhere between 0 to 90 degree, and let's see what will happen. So if we keep in this position, so this is the position between alpha from 0 to 90 degree. Now see, this is the axis of my phi s, okay, and this is the axis of phi s, okay. So this is my rotor induced flux. Now according to the Lenz's law, this phi r is producing due to this phi s, so it will oppose this phi s. So this phi r must have some branches which will oppose this phi s according to the Lenz's law. So for that, this should be the position of the phi r. Suppose some angle alpha between 0 to 90, this is the phi r. So I can from vector analysis I can decompose into two part. So one this part and another one just opposite to this phi s. So if I draw in this here, so this is my phi s, this is my phi r in alpha angle, and I have decomposed my phi r into two parts. So this is the branch which will oppose this part phi s according to the Lenz's law. Okay, now so to achieve this, the rotor induced magnetic field must be from C to D in this position. If it is in this position, then only a perpendicular portion of phi r will exist which will exactly opposite to the phi s. Now if we look in this position, this is north pole, this is south pole, and again this is north pole, so it will attract each other opposite pole, and we can see in other way that these two pole are same polarity, so this will repel each other. So that's why it is called repulsion motor. Now once the motor start and achieve certain amount speed, a centrifugal switch will cut this portion, that is the brush commutator portion, from the circuit, brush commutator portion, and short circuit the all the commutator segment, and this will short all the commutator segment will shorted by this centrifugal switch. So after it will start and attain certain speed, when the commutator segments are shorted, it will just acts as a squirrel cage rotor, just as squirrel cage rotor, and it will start rotating similar to the squirrel cage induction motor. Now if I want to change this rotation, so what I will do, I will keep this position of fire 90 degree ahead in this position. So again, this is north pole, this is south pole, and this is north pole, so it will repel each other, so the rotation will be anti-clockwise. Previously the rotation was in clockwise direction. So in this fashion, we can change the rotation of this repulsion start motor. Now if we draw the torque versus speed characteristics of repulsion type motor, so if I draw the torque versus speed characteristics, this is my torque axis, this is my speed axis. It has a very high starting torque during the repulsion period. So this way, very high starting torque, almost 300% excess starting torque than other motors. Okay, so this is basically the characteristics of a DC series motor. So it will basically acts as DC series motor, similar to DC series motor, with a very high starting torque. So it has also a very good speed regulation. So this motor basically use where a smooth speed regulation and high starting torque is required, like household refrigerator, lifts, hoists, garage air pumps, mixing machines. So these are the few application of repulsion type motor. So these are all about my today's class. We have discussed the working principle of a shaded pole structure. Also we have discussed the repulsion start motor. Okay, so this is all about today's class. In my next class we will discuss this repulsion reluctance start single phase induction motor, and also we will discuss starting maximum starting torque for different this type of motor. So thank you very much.